here and everything like that. So Dual Kevin here has to go up against now Momochu. So he just barely lost to Daigo.
Yeah.
Now has to go up against Momochu. At one point in time, Daigo and Mochi were like considered the two strongest in Street Fighter 4. And here we are, Dual Kevin back to back fighting against both of these guys.
You say you're our last hope, but look, when I was in Japan, I went to Sky Studio and Momochi and Choco gave me a t-shirt. So as far as I'm concerned, Dual Kevin has never given me a t-shirt. So Momochi is my last hope for making it in there, representing.
For getting more t-shirts.
Yeah,
huh?
He's representing Shinobi. As I don't know if any of the other Fudo players are going to make it so far. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, he's my last hope to make the top eight on loser's side, you know.
The power of a t-shirt.
Bro, you can bribe anybody with a t-shirt.
Have you seen how crazy people go with t-shirts?
The t-shirt is adorable. First of all, it's got Choco Blanca and Momochi and like little, you know,
like
pixelated. Yeah,
oh,
it's like,
okay.
Like pixel art. And then there's like an arcade cabinet in the background, and their dog is a little pixelated like in there as well. It's adorable. It's got a ninja back there. It's so good. And Dual Kevin, where's my shirt? That's what I thought. Let's go. Momochi, locked and loaded, the Evo Japan champion.
Man, Dual Kevin needs to make a shirt now, dude. he needs to get back into the favors of Seijam here. He's to give
well,
him a
look,
t-shirt.
James, you got to fight the American fight, and I got to fight the good fight for a quality t-shirt. We all have our fights that we have to pick.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
I know at home they're spamming the USA flags. I'm in there spamming the t-shirt. I got you. No problem.
T-shirt emotes. Yeah, there you go.
Can't have this bias. You know, tomorrow we're going to have God Save the Queen playing on commentary. We're going to have the Queen's English. So today, in the meantime, maybe the USA, we can pump it up.
Round one.
That's why you got to root for the US, man. Come on. Don't get baited by the t-shirt tech, Seijam.
Hey, to be fair, I don't see Problem X anywhere either. So
yeah, that's true. That's true.
They'll be commentating an all-Japanese affair, potentially. Well, whirlwind shot comes out.
Dual Kevin's going to see if he can do his best to counter that. Momochi is going with the Colleen this time.
It. Yeah, he's been playing a lot of Ken, but in a matchup like this, I don't really love picking Ken against a character like Rashid. You are so outmatched on the ground that I think picking a character like Colleen where you make the hits count way more and you have better buttons to deal with a character like Rashid, probably a better choice.
And when you activate that V-trigger, it becomes that much scarier. You know, that V-trigger from Colleen is just so good.
Excellent. Yeah, walk up for the throw. Working on Dizzy here. Dashes up and Dual Kevin with the interruption. All right, front throw. Working on this stun, and Momochi tries to walk up and block it, but Dual Kevin meets him halfway. Cross up. Excellent block.
And he tried to fake the bounce. You know, everybody, all the Rashid players always go onto the wall, back to the same side.
Yeah.
He stayed behind him, and Momochi read it. He blocked the whole thing, but Dual Kevin still opened him up afterwards and took first round.
Yeah, that was a really nice confirm from Momochi on the Crush Counter Fierce. Throws out the hail, and yeah, that's a punish. The thing is that the hail is so plus he has time to walk up, but because of that, he also had time to turn around and punish the V-reversal. Delay, Dual Kevin, excellent defense right there to just wait it out, not hit a button.
Ooh, try to go for a throw a little too far.
No,
now finally caught him low, and here we go. Pressure using that EX Tornado into V skill to get pressure, push Momochi towards the corner. Oh, but Momochi makes it out with the V reversal. Both of them with escape V reversals.
Yeah, you see, just Momochi's relaxed. In neutral, he is chilling, waiting it out. And Dual Kevin has done a good job not being baited by whiffing a lot against Momochi, although that is a big bet. EX, a lot of scaling on this, so the damage isn't too crazy.
Yeah, gets the knockdown into the fake safe jump and goes for the throw instead, and then immediately followed by the Fierce directly into the Parabellum.
Yeah, I mean, he just committed, right? Just Fierce, light Parabellum, and it happened to hit, so he's like, all right, I'll take it.
Yeah, I wonder if that was a confirm or if he was just going to do that no matter what.
Not sure. Rolls in for the pressure. The double jump to escape. That's one thing. Rashid's pretty good at sniping those jumps, so I like Momochi committing to the double jump.
Nice backdash in the corner. Escapes the throw. Dual Kevin. Oh, gets in there with the crouching heavy punch. Confirming the V skill.
Yeah, this is really good, actually. I mean, it gives you solid damage as well. Medium punch, spear for the knockdown, and the EX mixer.
Okay.
His success ratio back on that's been very high.
Yeah, back into the corner. It's just that once you get Rashid knocked down, you just want to start applying that pressure.
Yeah, his ability to escape the corner is very solid. Back throw. I think Momochi respected the XDP. And Momochi has a lot of bar, but not a lot of life. The snipe on the jump back.
Yeah, that's always the thing, right? When you're just chilling inside that tornado, you're waiting to see what the opponent does. They can't poke at you because they just extend their hurtbox into the V-trigger one. Saw Momochi jump back, chase him down with the Eagle Spike.
Yeah, I was clean from Dual Cabin. Round one. So we'll see what he's got in this next game here. I think really if you're Momochi, the adjustment has to be a little bit more of your big buttons and neutral, because Dual Kevin has kind of been controlling that range really well with his down fierce and other stuff. I'd like to see Momochi hit fierce a little bit more. He's like uncharacteristically few amount of fierces for Colleen.
Yeah.
He's a little too safe.
Look at these confirms from Dual Kevin. Two of them, just two of them, pushed Momochi all the way into the corner already. No anti-air that time though. So that means Momochi's gonna get the back throw, switch sides, punishes the V reversal escape.
Yeah, he could see it during the freeze frame that that's what Dual Kevin was doing. So he had all the time in the world and the clean little throw bait to get the round. Nice work from Momochi. I have been really impressed with the way Dual Kevin's been playing on the ground so far, though. This is not an easy player to beat up on the ground, right? But he's been doing a good job of really kind of using his normals well. And also, I feel like the crouching heavy punch has been a real hero for him. Nice! Walks back, lets Momochi whiff the throw, sticks out the fierce. Oh, missed the punish.
Okay, there we go. Blocks the EX Eagle Spike. He's gonna get good damage here. I mean, actually turned out to be decent damage, but has the corner position. More importantly, the Dual Kevin waking up with a standing light kick.
Yeah, right into the mixer after. He believed it was gonna hit, so he was all in.
Yeah, but again, you know, for a mixer, you can confirm it, right? If you do light kick right into the mixer and it hits, then you keep mashing, get the knockdown. If not, then you just let it go. Minus two on block.
Walk up wait from Momochi like three or four times in a row. Yeah, he's just hanging out in that range. Ooh. He just walks up, respects Dual Kevin's big buttons, and says, all right, I'm not going to do anything.
Can't believe Momochi even just walked up there for the throw. Didn't even dash. Now Dual Kevin has the corner position, tries to activate the V-trigger, and I love that Momochi walked up to block it off to get rid of it, but then got clipped by the tornado, trying to escape with a backdash in the corner. Not enough.
That was a great snipe and the back throw. Dual Kevin ready for it, and that's a big backdash in the corner from Momochi. I love that Dual Kevin scouted it immediately. He's like, let me hit this light kick after, not let him get away with it. And look at this set point over Momochi here. It's the Evo Japan champion.
And, you know, a good amount of resources as well. It's not like he's even far behind on the super meter at all.
Big crush early. Dual Kevin, full resources, has the corner position. Momochi with nothing to interrupt. V reversals out, though.
But look at this. Okay, finally Dual Kevin has lost a little bit of health. It took 25, it took a whole fourth of the round.
Wow, backdash in the corner. Not snipes.
A bunch of times I've seen Dual Kevin do that now.
Yeah, it's a good option if you think people are going to throw or meet you with a light button. You flip out in the air and you'll take it. You're like, yep, perfect. Flip out. I avoid that situation or I get away from the throw. Punish! This is huge.
Yeah, look at this. All the way into the corner.
Going for the throw. Momochi with the break.
The counter hit. Not enough to kill. But Dual Kevin is right there in the roundhouse and chase the backdash. Dual Kevin has made it to top 8 on loser's side. The only non-Japanese player to make it there.
And you can see how much he's feeling it. SFL grinding all these events back to back to back. And Dual Kevin is in top 8 of a premier event on the CPT.
Now, when their team, Team Frost, lost in the Street Fighter League, you could see how disappointed it was. And I was talking to him, and he was like, man, well, you know what, next time. And I just looked at him and was like, you're young. You've got plenty of opportunities. And you know what? Who knew that one was going to come immediately the next day? Dual Kevin here in top 8 mm-hmm. at CEO, one of the biggest tournaments for Street Fighter V of the year.
Yeah, and he's got to be feeling fantastic about that.